Hello, Team 2021 participants. My name is Miguel Ángel Conde. I come from the University of León, and I'm here to talk about RoboSteam project, and more specifically about the pilot phases of this project. In the next slide, we will talk about it. Current society demands professionals adapted to our digital reality. This means that they should have achieved what is known as 21st century skills, and they should be flexible enough to deal with a changeable context as is the one in which we are involved. This makes it especially necessary to facilitate the acquisition of such a skill through the integration of STEAM-related activities in the present educational pathways and to foster competencies such as computational thinking. Both tasks are hard. It is not enough to include some technology subjects in the educational plan. The development of these competencies must be something included in all the subjects, and the best way to facilitate this is using active methodologies and using engaging tools for the students. In this context emerged RoboSteam project. It is an Erasmus Plus project that involves 8 partners from 4 different countries, 4 schools and 4 universities, with the aims to define a methodology and a set of tools that help learners to develop computational thinking by using or programming physical devices and robotics in pre-university education stages. In the 4 schools, and with an additional one, an associate partner, we have carried out several pilot phases to validate the project outcomes, and this is what we are going to present in this work. In these pilots, students apply challenge-based learning and physical devices and robotics to address different challenges. The pilot phase 1 is developed by 5 secondary schools with their students from 12 to 16 years old. The pilot consists of a first diagnosis phase. Later, the challenges will be posed for small students groups and they will be addressed by them. And finally, the results will be analyzed during an evaluation phase. The activity was scheduled to be completed between the project months 9 and 17, although this task was delayed because it requires for the result of previous activities completed during the first year and because of COVID-19. In this case, we use mini challenges because they can be addressed during a semester in an easier and more controlled way than with a complete challenge. On the slide, there is a description of one of these mini challenges. The pilot phase 2 is a second testing stage. And on it, the secondary schools are involved again. They should develop the same activities than in pilot 1, and the same student groups are involved in the challenges. In this case, students can choose another challenge for a mini challenge defined by a partner from a different socioeconomic context. The pilot was scheduled between months 12 and 19, and again we have problems with COVID-19. In fact, in this case, the classes included in the pilots were discontinued and the partners look for ways to finish it in a virtual way. On the slide, it's possible to see the sample of students, teachers and other staff involved during the pilots, and we can see that we have more than 1,000 persons involved on them. Regarding the possible measure instruments to use, we have employee-validated instruments in order to measure the perception of the students about STEM. For this, we use the STEM Semantic Survey. The collaboration between students in groups. For this, we use the commercial rubric and a computational thinking test to measure the acquisition of such competence. In addition, we have used other rubrics and metrics employed by the hosting, the pilot hosting institutions. On the tables, we can see the results for the indicators related with time and nano challenges on the top left, and on the bottom right we can see a table with the data related with the STEM Semantic Survey, which shows a very good perception or a good perception for this kind of disciplines. And here we have some of the results produced during the project, the nano challenges and the prototypes that have addressed the different challenges proposed. As conclusions, we can say that the pilot have shown us that the project's aims have been achieved, and that the use of agile methodologies and physical devices and robotics help integrate in STEM and developing computational thinking. However, we should consider that there are different contexts, and whatever we use should be flexible enough in order to it can be used. Well, this is all, and if you have any kind of questions, I will see you on Team 2021.